So I had just gotten through a divorce, gotten out of a house that was way more than what we needed, what we could afford. Prior to the divorce, it was a big shift in income, downward shift in income, and there I was stuck with just over $84,000 worth of credit card debt and a credit score that had plummeted practically to single digits for all intents and purposes, but it was down around a 400. And mounting, all that debt, $84,500 about on credit card debt at ridiculous interest rates. Definitely seemed to be quite an insurmountable mountain of debt that lay ahead of me there. And the idea of going through a bankruptcy was very unappealing to me. Didn't want to do that. I knew it was going to have very, very long-term impact, negative impact. But I didn't know what to do. That was about when I met Ryan at the credit movement and talked with him a couple quick conversations, consolidated some of the debt, renegotiated a lot of the interest rates, I think all of the interest rates on that, and really came up with a very reasonable, palpable budget for me to work to. I got back on my feet, professionally focused. My life got back, being single in my mid-30s again, my life got back together. I was enjoying it in all aspects. And over 5 years, I was able to pay off all that debt, paid off over $84,000 in debt. I improved my credit score to about an 820. I think I'm around an 840 now. So fantastic credit score. And, within a year or two after that, sticking with that budget, I bought a new truck, I bought a new SUV, a snowmobile, dirt bike, camper. And I'm liquid. I paid cash for all of it. So the only debt I have now is a mortgage on a rental property that's cash flowing very well for me. And that's over about a 7 year period. And really the catalyst for all of it was the program, was a conversation, a very simple program, more of not even a program, just a few intelligent steps, a few intelligent moves that Ryan guided me into with the credit movement. Yeah. Put me in the right direction. Before I met Ryan, I had no idea how long this was going to take. It's $84,000 and change. That was more than I made ever in 1 year of my life prior to meeting Ryan. I had no idea what I was going to do. Working with Ryan at the credit movement, a couple of the key components to me being successful that he taught me about or helped me set up and structure was renegotiating the debt with the credit cards, taking those interest rates and working with the credit card to put a more favorable rate to really bring that down, a lot of them to 0%. And then that made it much easier to pay off. If you can make minimums on 0% and pay heavier where you're paying interest, obviously that's working in your favor. And then really creating a budget for myself, something that left me money to pay down my debt, but was reasonable. It wasn't so shoestring that I'd stand no chance of sticking to it. Those were the two real key pillars for me being successful and getting through the program, getting through a program that allowed me to be debt-free in 5 years. Years later, if I hadn't been able to restructure the debt and create a budget and stick to it and pay things off in 5 years, I'm sure I'd still be paying on that debt. I'm sure the interest would be over $40,000 and now. It made a huge difference. And then by having the discipline over that time of being on that type of a budget, even expanding, giving myself some more financial freedom, I still managed to save up and be able to pay cash for a new vehicle, a new SUV, a snowmobile, dirt bike, a camper. I'm paying cash for things now. I'm not putting things on credit cards. I'm not in a position where I'm ever going to get into debt like that again. I track the money I spend. I now have the discipline of sticking to a budget, and I don't spend money I don't have. It's a painful lesson, an expensive lesson, but an incredibly valuable lesson that once you're out from under that crushing mountain of debt, you're not gonna forget about it. You're gonna carry that painful memory and the great feeling that you have afterwards of not having any debt, of being able to do what you want to do, of being able to take a vacation, going to New Zealand for 3 weeks. of going to the Caribbean for a week vacation because you have the money. You're not living chasing your payments. You're living ahead of them. And yeah, once you have that feeling after paying things off, you won't go back. I paid off $84,000 in debt in 5 years by running a budget. I still run a budget. It's much looser. It has more play money in it. But it's still, instead of paying off debt, I'm putting money into savings. So if I want to buy a new fun car or another dirt bike or go on a week to the Caribbean, I've got the cash. I'm not financing it and then paying interest on it and then something else goes wrong and it snowballs again.
So if you were to get a mortgage now with your credit where it is versus the mortgages that you had in the past before, maybe you didn't try to get a mortgage.
I could. I was going to fucking finance a 480, 450. But yeah, so when, after I had most of my debt paid off, because I had been making so many timely payments, I was able to get a very low mortgage, just above 4%, on a house that I lived in. And right before I moved out and turned it into an investment property, I refinanced it under 3%. So because of the program, because of what I did to pay down the debt, and showing the credit agencies that consistent payment for all those years, even though I still had a little bit when I bought that house, I was able to get a very good mortgage rate. And then 3 years later, a rock bottom mortgage rate because I had no other debt.
So looking back at it, would you say that the things you applied were actually really easy? It was just a matter of knowing what to do?
The biggest thing was knowing what to do. I never would have thought to call the credit cards and try to negotiate a 0%. Like, never crossed my mind. And in fact, that was really the keystone to the whole program. I didn't get them all to 0%. One or two of them a couple of them I wasn't able to get to 0% were the ones I obviously paid first. But that was a keystone. No, nothing about what he suggested and set up was complex or sophisticated. Yes, a budget takes a little bit of discipline, but so does anything. Working out or going to school, anything you really want takes a little discipline to get the reward. It wasn't challenging, it wasn't difficult, it wasn't rocket science. It was just executing on the simplest X's and O's and ones and zeros.
So what was the actual point swing in your credit score?
My credit score point swing was about 380 points from around a 450, 460 at the worst. I'm around an 820 now. And when I refinanced about 2 years ago, I was over 800 then as well. So in 5 years, a 400 point swing, 350 point swing.
Awesome. Wow. Sweet, dude.
For me, working with Ryan at the credit movement, the two key tenets that really made everything work, the first being, I didn't even know you could call a credit card and negotiate down the interest rate. Turns out you can. Well, that's a really big deal to not be paying a few hundred bucks a month in interest. Yeah, the credit movement told me what to say on the call. I didn't know what to say. I didn't know you could even do it. But that's a key piece, is knowing what to say and how to say it to the banks, to the credit cards, so that they will work with you. That was huge. That was massively important for me.
Just speaking their language.
Speaking their language, yep. Using the words and structuring your sentence exactly as they told me to at the credit movement, I got the results. I got down to zero and close to zero interest rates from seven different credit cards. That made a huge difference. It was a massive impact. And where my money went every month, my monthly payment instead of interest, I paid down the debt itself. It's huge.
That's a win.
Yeah. Fuck the banks. The second big pillar that the credit movement helped me really put into place to get out of that mountain of debt was budgeting myself. It sounds so simple. We've all read about it and heard about it. But sometimes it's actually, you need a little kick in the butt to do it, to get started, to create it, and then a month or two of hand-holding to get through that first bit of discipline. And once you realize you can do it, credit card debt starts going away. It goes from 7 cards to 5 to 2. You pay off the last one. And then instead of sending out a couple $1,000 a month, it's yours to keep. You can adjust that budget and give yourself some more room to have fun every month. But I've stayed on that budget for almost 3 additional years now. And that's really helped my financial situation tremendously. I'm not spending money I don't have. I have some cash in the bank so that I can do things I want or buy things I want or splurge a little here. But by keeping a budget, I don't fool myself into thinking I didn't do it. I know when I did it. I can see it. It shows up every month in my budget. Oops, I went over. Well, that's okay if you do it now and then. But if you're doing it every month, it's a problem. If you're not keeping a budget, you don't know. If you are keeping a budget, then you know. It's been a huge value to me continuing to do that. And I never would have started it if I didn't have to pay off $84,000 in debt. But because I did and was successful, and now I don't have the debt and I don't have that crushing weight, it's a heck of a lot easier to stay on a budget. And really, credit movement helped me get in that position where I am today. Here I am a couple years later, and I've stuck with the budget, I've stuck with the plan, I've continued to implement and stay disciplined with everything I learned through the credit movement. And I'm looking at a large piece of real estate. I'm pre-approved for a $2 million piece of real estate. That's a little bit more than I think I need, but it's fantastic to be in that position and have that option. And now I'm shopping for real estate, and I'm pre-approved for $2 million on a 3%, 3.25% interest rate because my credit score is really exceptional. 820 is what's driving that approval, what's driving those options for me.
What a change from a couple of years ago.
A little bit. I don't know if you're saying that kind of for the camera or just like...
No, I'm not going to use my voice in any of that.
Yeah, I'm good. I didn't think so, but...
But that's fucking awesome.
Yeah, they'll pre-approve me for a bigger piece of real estate. Yeah, it's been a couple months. They'll give me all the fucking money in the world, my personal credit, personal financial state.
Yeah.
Add up the two columns and, yeah, to anybody that I knew who was in a bad spot, in a pinch with a credit score or getting out of control with debt, I'd absolutely recommend calling the guys at the credit movement, giving them a chance, listening to what they have to say and implementing what they have to say. Nothing's rocket science. It's simple ones and zeros, the most basic blocking and tackling in the financial world. You just gotta do it and know what to do and know how to do it and how to talk to the financial institutions that are holding your balls in the fire.
Love it. Awesome. Fuck yeah, man.
I was in the mid-low 400s. I didn't even look. I didn't have any money to spend. And now, you know what? I don't even look again because I know I'm over 800. Is it 820 or 830? I don't know. It doesn't matter. It's fine. Before that, and I was like, you know, over 800. I got that credit card and it gave me like a $40,000 credit limit. So, in my opinion, kind of obscene, huge. And now I'm like 820, 830, 825, like, cool. Awesome. All I have to do is get this fucking credit card to pay $100 a year. Yeah. You know, you get all the points and fucking some bullshit perks that I fly enough for work that the perks cover.
Yeah.
You should just